ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 27th பாசுரம். கூடாரை வெல்லும் சீர் கோவிந்தா உந்தன்னை பாடிப்பறை கொண்டு யாம் பெரு சன்மானம் நாடு புகழும் பரிசினால் நன்றாக சூடகமே தொள்வளையே தோடே செவிப்பூவே பாடகமே என்றனைய பல்கலனும் யாமணிவோம் ஆடையுடுப்போம் அதன் பின்னே பார்ச்சோறு மூடனை பெய்து முழங்கை வழிவார கூடியிருந்து குளிர்ந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் கோ அண்ட் மீட் த லார்ட் அண்ட் ஸ்டார்ட் ஹேவிங் அ கான்வர்சேஷன் வித் ஹிம். இன் தேட் தே டெல் ஹிம் தட் தே ஹவ் கம் டு பெர்ஃபார்ம் த மார்கழி நோன்பு, மார்கழி நீராடுவான், ஷி செட் இன் த ப்ரீவியஸ் பாசுரம். And she says that this is in accordance with what the Gopikas did earlier. So, in order to attain the Lord, they have chosen this path which was shown by their predecessors or elders. So, she says, Melayar Seivanagal. And what was shown by these elders? It was shown that they need certain things to perform this Vrata. They needed certain things and these things were to be obtained from the Lord himself. So, in the 26th Pasuram, Andal enlisted the different items that were required to complete the Margari Vrata or Pavai Nombu. Once she finished her list, the Lord was a little startled because he had to supply that list of items for not only Andal but all her friends who had assembled there. And it seemed that the number was really huge. According to certain commentators, they were apparently around 5 lakh people present there. So, the Lord himself was a little troubled, thinking as to how he would handle giving so many things to so many people. So, Andal reminds him and says that, O Lord, you are not an ordinary one. You are Ali Nilayai, the one who can sleep on a banyan leaf having gobbled up the whole world. So, for you, giving these things to so many people is absolutely no issue. You can give it away as easily as it would be for a child to play. It's just child's play for you. So, the Lord is about to agree to give them all these things. But then he gets another doubt saying that what would happen if everybody around Gokulam or Srivilliputtur come to know of what is happening? So, if they come and create some hindrance, what will I do? If somebody will stop me from giving you all these things, how do I handle that? To this, Andal starts replying in this pasuram. She says, O Lord, who are you? You are koodarai vellum seer Govinda. You are somebody who has the capacity to win over all kinds of enemies. Koodar refers to enemies. Koodarai vellum means the one who wins over enemies. And you have that quality, seer, of winning over enemies. So you are koodarai vellum seer Govinda. Now, Andal is trying to say that anybody who tries to go against the Lord is his enemy. Which in this case, now the Lord is apparently showing out that the people around Gokulam or the people around Srivilliputtur who are not aware of the real intentions of these girls may become a hindrance to the Lord granting them these boons. So, Andal is saying, even if those people stand in opposition of you, you have the capability of winning over them by your seer, guna, quality. Meaning, the Lord doesn't have to actually fight with enemies to win over them. He can just show his beautiful characteristics and qualities and win their hearts over by that. That is what he did even in the Ramayana, they say. Ravana fought with Rama and he was all praises for Rama. Rama might have been his enemy on the battlefield, but by showing his valor and strength and beauty of fighting, Rama won over the heart of Ravana as a warrior. Ravana says, Tammanye Raghavam Veeram Narayana Manamayam. Looking at the valor of Rama, I feel he is Narayana himself. He is so strong and so courageous and such a wonderful warrior. So Ravana's heart was won over by Rama, by his valor, strength and his quality, that quality of mercy when he let Ravana go, when Ravana was about to be defeated by him the first time. Ravana stood in the battlefield weaponless. Rama could have killed him, but he chose not to kill him and gave him another chance. So this quality of his, the valor that he had shown previously on the battlefield, all these aspects, all these qualities, won over the heart of the enemy Ravana. So thus, the Lord is koodArai vellum seer, the one who wins over the opponent by his qualities. Now here, Andal is saying that, O Lord, I know that you have this quality from your Ramavatara. So, ideally speaking, she should have called out to him as koodArai vellum seer Rama or Raghava, something like that. Because she has understood this quality of the Lord of winning over the opponent by his guna from the Ramavatara. So, she should have addressed him as Rama here. But she says, koodArai vellum seer Govinda. She calls him as Govinda now. Why is she calling him out as Govinda? Because Govinda is a very special name for Andal, it seems. Govinda is a name given to Lord Narayana for many reasons. The first reason being that he saved Go, the earth, from the clutches of a demon in the Varahavatara. So, Bhumi Devi was saved by Varahavatara and Bhumi Devi bears the name Go. So, Varaha Swami is also known as Govinda, the one who saved Go Bhumi. Andal, being the incarnation of Bhumi Devi, remembers this quality of the Lord when he won over that opponent Hiranyaksha and brought her back. So, he showed his quality of valor and strength to that opponent and brought her back. So, remembering that, she calls him out as Govinda here, koodArai vellum seer Govinda. This is one meaning of the word Govinda. Another aspect that Andal remembers and calls Govinda is that in the Krishna Avatara, Lord Krishna was given the name Govinda, the title Govinda, in an episode called the Govinda Pattabhishekam. And when did this happen? This happened after the Lord held mountain Govardhana for 7 days and seven nights. After he held the mountain for all this time, Indra realized his mistake, came and surrendered to the Lord and asked him for forgiveness, which the Lord granted. And then Indra wanted to coronate the Lord as Govinda. So, he called out for Kamadhenu from Swargaloka or from the heaven. Kamadhenu, the celestial cow, and she came and poured out her divine milk on the Lord and did coronation or Pattabhishekam for him, giving the title Govinda. She remembers this Govinda too when she says koodArai vellum seer Govinda. Now, this Govinda is also the one who won over the enemy by his guna quality. How is that? Let us understand. When Indra decided to torment Gokulam with rains, torrential rains, the Lord Krishna, Narayana, being the Supreme Being, had the power to stop the rain then and there. He could have combated Indra and stopped the rain at that moment itself. But the Lord did not choose to do this. Instead, he offered protection to his refugees from the rain and let Indra give out his wrath as much as he wanted. Because the Lord does not like to fight at the first instant. He always wants to give a chance to the opponent. So the Lord gave him a chance and saw, let him harm how much ever as he can. And at some point, if he is going to get repentance in his mind, if he is going to understand his mistake and come back to me, I am ready to grant him asylum. So, to give Indra a chance, he waited for him to spit out his fury for 7 whole days and nights. Thus, by showing this quality of tolerance, the Lord won over Indra, his opponent at that time. So he became koodArai vellum sheer Govinda. He took up the title Govinda given by Indra as a mark of giving him forgiveness and granting him mercy. So Andal says, O Lord, mighty opponents like Ravana, like Hiranyaksha, like Indra have all been won over by your qualities, and they were once having some kind of vengeance in their minds against you. But here, the ones whom you are apparently thinking will cause hindrance or will be your opponents are mere people who are worried about their girls or daughters. So what kind of harm can they give to you? And how easy would it be for you to show your qualities and win them over? Do you think it's a big deal for you? Not at all. And as such, they are all fond of you, O Lord. They are all great fans of your qualities. And so, by showing your seer quality, O Govinda, you will definitely win over them. koodArai vellum seer Govinda. And so, you please come out and give us whatever we ask for. In fact, we would now like to tell you that the list that we said in the previous pasuram is not complete yet. We still have a little more to ask of you. Now the Lord smiles. He says, I was thinking whether to give you the first list fully at all. And now you are saying that you have more to ask of me. Anyways, let me hear fully what you have to say, he says. And so the girls go ahead to say, Undannai paadi parai kondu yam peru sanmanam. By singing your glory, Undannai paadi parai kondu, and getting all those things that we have asked of you in the previous pasuram, like parai, we also continue to ask you for certain more things. Okay, so by this statement, Andal ensures that she is getting what she has already asked for. She says that, I know you will grant us parai, etc. that we have asked you in the previous pasuram. And further, we also want to be glorified by you. We want to get sanmanam from you. We want to get certain items of regard from you. So let us give you that list now. And this sanmanam or this present that you are going to give us should be given out in public, because just now we realized that you are having some kind of hitch when we ask you in person for certain things. So you make it public. There is no need of hiding anything from anybody. Let the world know what you are giving to us. Nadu pugalum parisinal nandraga. Let the entire world know what you are going to give us. Nadu pugalum. Let the entire country know about the presents that you are going to bestow on us. Parisinal nandraga. And what are the presents that we are asking of you now? We are asking for certain very girly items that we would like to wear and be with you and enjoy your company. We want to be decked up and look good so that we can enjoy in your company, having adorned ourselves with good jewelry and clothing. Because if you remember, we had said that during the period of the Vrata, we would not be dressing up much. Mayittezhudhom malarittu naam mudiyom was one of the aspects that was said in the second pasuram. We said we will not deck ourselves up till the end of the Vrata. So, once we finish this Vrata by getting all this parai and other things from you, we want to adorn ourselves with jewelry and good clothing and then be in your company. And this jewelry and clothing we wish to get from you only. You only should give it to us as presents. That would be the most appropriate way of getting these things. So, what kind of jewelry these people want, that is also well defined by Andal. She says, we want sudagame. Sudagam refers to the head ornament or rakudi as they call. And then she says, we need tolvalaye. Tolvalaye is the shoulder ornament. Then she wants tode. Todu refers to earring. Sevipuve, she says. Sevipu is an ornament which is worn on the upper part of the ear. Now, this is a kind of modern trend that we see, that women pierce their ears at more than one place. The normal place of piercing is the one where we wear the normal earring, and that normal earring is called todu. And if the ear is pierced a little on the upper side of the ear and an ornament is worn there, that ornament is called sevipu. Andal was well aware of all this trend right then. So she has specifically asked for both todu and sevipu. And then she says, we need padagame. Padagame refers to anklets. So basically, she's asking for ornaments to adorn herself and her friends from head to foot, from sudagam to padagam. That is, from the head ornament up to the anklet. So we wish to adorn ourselves with all kind of jewelry so that, oh Lord, when we look at you, we want you to think that we have been graced by you in all possible ways. We asked that we have to be in your company in the best possible way, and you have granted that to us. So just to show you that we are wearing all that you have given us, we want to be blessed by you from head to toe. And she says, fine, now that we have told you what jewelry we need, next we will tell you what kind of clothing we need to. Andal again here is very particular about how women today are. Or rather, she knew the trend in vogue today, that normally we people tend to choose accessories first and then go ahead to choose the clothing. So also Andal has described accessories first, and followed by that she speaks about clothing. She says, we need palkalanum yamani vom adayudupom. Wearing all these accessories, we want suitable clothes for it. Adayudupom. Suitable clothes, she says. Here, this suitability is pertaining to the accessories. That is one aspect. Another aspect, it seems, commentators say, that we need suitable clothing so that it matches your clothing. Parasparam parivartaniyam. Our clothing should be such that it should be matching to you. And not just matching to you, but something that can be exchanged between us. Lord Krishna was the one who wore pitambara, who wore colorful clothes. And these girls were the ones who wore saris. So, they are saying that their saris and the Lord's pitambara should be exchangeable amongst themselves. So they should be so similar that they could even exchange and wear one another's clothing. So that kind of similarity, that kind of match, that kind of proximity they wanted with the Lord. And so they are saying that we want adayudupom, which is exchangeable with each other. So once they got decked up and dressed like this, this is all the list that they want after the vratam that they are talking about. So to perform the vratam, whatever they needed, they asked in the previous pasuram. And after the vratam, whatever they wanted Krishna to give it out in public. And what they wanted was beautiful accessories and corresponding clothing. Once they adorned themselves with this kind of clothing, they wanted to have food with Krishna, it seems. Now, what is the enjoyment that these girls are talking about? They wanted to be with the Lord at all times. They wanted to play with him. They wanted to eat with him. They wanted to talk to him. And they wanted his company all the time. So here, Andal is saying that once we deck up and get ready, we all want to have a nice lunch with you. And what would be the menu of that lunch? She says, Adan pinne parchoru mudanai peidu mulangai valivara. We all want to have lunch together with you. And what is the menu? We want pal soru, that is kshirana or sweet milk porridge. And she says this should be rich sweet milk porridge, which is laden with ghee. How much of ghee should it have? When we hold on to that kshirana or palsoru, this ghee should come flowing down the arm, it seems. That richness of food they wanted to have with Krishna. Why? Because these girls have been not having good food all this time. They have been actually on meager meals. Because they said, neyunnom palunnom. We are not going to have ghee and milk all through the vrata, they say. So since they have not had all these bhogya items all this time, now that they have achieved their bhogya Krishna after the completion of the vrata, they want to have these mundane bhogya items like ghee and milk also. So they talk about palsoru, sweet milk porridge, which is laden with ghee, moodanai peidu mulangai valivara, and all this we wish to have in your divine company, O Lord. So she says, koodi irundu kulirndelor embavai. The Lord is listening very patiently to the girls describe so much in detail about what they want after the vrata. And then now he is going to ask them a few questions before he actually grants what they want. Let us see what the questions are in tomorrow's pasana.